Welcome friends. Today we are going to discuss the unit number 4, that is stresses in beams. Okay. There are two types of stresses in beams. That is, first one is what? Bending stresses in beams. And second, that is shear stresses in beams. Okay, today we are going to discuss, or we are going to focus on that first one, that is bending stresses in beams. Okay, in this chapter we are going to focus on what? That the numericals based on the bending stresses. For that one, there is one derivation to find out the, or to derive the formula, that is Flexure formula. Now, what is the Flexure formula? The Flexure formula is nothing but the Flexure formula is given by M by I is equal to sigma by Y is equal to E by R. So what is meant by M? M is nothing but what? Bending moment. Okay. Next is what? I. I is nothing but what? Moment of inertia. Next, sigma. Sigma is nothing but what? Bending stresses. Next, y. Y is nothing but what? Distance from neutral axis. Okay, neutral axis where the all stresses are zero. Okay, next, E. E is nothing but what? Young's modulus. And next, R. R is nothing but what? Radius of curvature. Okay, so we directly focus on the numericals based on this formula. In that one, formula is that M by I is equal to sigma by Y is equal to E by R, where E and R, these are the constants. Okay, so simply formula mainly based on M by I is equal to sigma by Y. On this formula we are going to see the numericals, and numericals are too much important in this chapter, because in examination numericals are asked on this unit. Okay, so we directly see the numerical. Okay, so see this numerical. Okay, a cantilever of length 2 meter fails when a load of 2 kilonewton is applied at the free end. Okay, if the section of the beam is 14 to 60 mm, find the stresses at the failure. So we have to find out the stress at failure. Okay, because what? Here load is applied. At that load, this what? Cantilever is fails. Okay, so at that time we want to find out the stress at failure, that is bending stress. Okay, so I will draw the figure. Okay, based on this numerical, this cantilever of length 2 meter. Okay, this is what? Span. Next is what? When load of 2 kilonewton is applied at the free end. At the free end, load is what? 2 kilonewton. Okay, so, and again this section is given, the beam section is given, that is what? 40 into 60. This 40 is what? 40 mm wide and 60 mm what? Deep. So firstly, write down whatever given data. So what is the given data? See here, Next, first one is what? Length. That is what? 2 meter. Convert into mm. 2000 mm. Next is what? W. That is load. 2 kilo Newton. Convert into Newton. 2 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Okay. Next, B. That is what? Breadth. That is 40 mm wide. And next, D. That is depth. That is 60 mm. Okay. Now, let's focus on the formula. What is the formula? M by I is equal to sigma by Y. Okay. So, see here. We must know the formula. I will convert this formula into next one. M is equal to sigma by Y into I. Okay. So, instead, M is equal to sigma into this I divided by Y. This I divided by Y, this is nothing but what? Sigma into Z. Z is nothing but what? Sectional modulus. We already seen in unit number 3, that is in chapter combined stresses. Okay. So, this is formula comes here. M is equal to sigma into Z. So, we want to find out this sigma. So, first thing is that we must find out this M and Z. So, first thing, find out section modulus of rectangular section. So, simply Z is equal to what? BD square by 6. So, what is the value of B? 40. What is the value of D? 60 square divided by this 6. So, simply we get the value 24 okay, 24,000 mm cube. Okay, next is what? We got the value Z here. So, next is what? We got value of Z. Next, we have to find out this M. So, second is what? Find out maximum bending moment for a cantilever. So, what is the formula? M is equal to W into L. So, what is the value of W? W is what? 2 into 10 raised to 3 into L, that is 2000. So, what we get value? 4 into 10 raised to 6 Newton mm. This is what? M. Okay. Now, use a formula. That is what? Flexure formula. To find out bending stress. What is the formula?